The biathlon is one of only three sports at the Universiade where men and women can compete side by side. The others, of course, being cross-country and figure skating. With the mass starts to come on Thursday and Friday, it was time on Wednesday for the mixed relay. 10 nations entered teams of four, two men and two women. The women lead out, they do 6 kilometres and two shootings each. They're followed by the men who have to go slightly further, 7.5 k's for them, also with two shootings. Well, the favourites for this one, undoubtedly the Russians, three of whom had already clambered onto the podium earlier in the games, leaving Larisa Kuznetsova as the only member of the team yet to enjoy a top three finish. She did her bit for the team, getting them to the first exchange in second spot and in a good position to tackle the Czech Republic. Their lead out lady, Jitka Landova, who had already picked up bronze in the women's 15 kilometres. She missed out with one shot there, but she made sure to hand over in first place with a 6 second lead over the Russians. At that point, it was Fialkova leading, but as I say, Landova took up the lead. She was able to hand over in front spot. The Russians 6 seconds back. Following them, Ukraine and the French. Well, the Russians have a good record in the event since it was introduced 4 years ago in Harbin in China. They took gold in that inaugural event, followed up with silver 2 years ago behind Ukraine in Turkey. Tatiana Semenova had already collected two bronze medals in the 10K and the 7.5, and it fell to her to move the Russians into the lead. She missed once with the rifle, but she was quick enough over the snow to build an 11-second lead over the Ukrainians. Second Czech girl, Kristina Serna, struggled. She could only hand over in fourth place, with the French moving up to the bronze medals. Then it was the turn of the men, and here the Russians had the form to suggest this was going to be plain sailing. Sergei Kliachin had already won gold in the 20k and silver in the 12.5k pursuit. He was in no mood to take any prisoners. He missed with one of his targets. By the time he had made his handover, the Russians had increased their lead to 1 minute 24 seconds. Ukraine, the defending champions from Turkey, had a bit of brass in their ranks. Vitaly Kalchitsky took silver in the 10K. But the Russians allowed to escape as he was struggling to find the targets. At the final changeover, the French were still third, but just 17 seconds ahead of the Czechs. The final leg, a pleasant stroll really for Alexander Penchenkin. Already with one gold in his pocket after the 12.5 kilometre pursuit. He was on course for another one. Dead eye on the rifle range, no misses, and another gold medal beckoning. Behind him, Dmitry Pedrushny, bronze medalist in the 10K. He was doing his best to make up time, but another lapse on the shooting range meant there was no real contest. Battle for third was a close one. Tomas Krupčík getting the better of Mathieu Vincent. Czechs coming in to take the bronze, while France, silver medalist in 2009, finished off the podium in fourth. Pedrushny collecting the flag on the way to signal gold for Russia. Pedrushny following him home. 1 minute and 28 seconds later, that was silver for Ukraine. As I say, it was a tight battle for third, but in the end, it was the strength of the Czech Republic that came through, 2.5 minutes behind the Russians. France having to settle on this occasion for fourth. Great day for Russia, though. That's their seventh medal in the biathlon. Three of them have been gold.